Hey viewers, welcome to this video presentation today. Peter here, University of Nairobi Faculty of Law, Kisumu Campus. Today's topic is going to look at two important concepts in the jurisprudence. One, the pragmatism, and two, we are going to look at activism. Whenever we talk in terms of judicial or legal pragmatism or judicial or legal activism, we are simply referring ourselves to the American realism, in which Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes Jr. in the 1930s demonstrated a geniality in the understanding of law and of the jurisprudence back then, in which the reading of law, the meaning and the philosophy and the knowledge around law should be defined within the activities taking place in the courtroom. That is what the lawyers, advocates are arguing about while defending their cases before the judge. And most importantly, the judge, when the judge retires back into his or her chambers to draw the judgment and come out with the final ruling and verdict. In this American approach, the so-called American realism, we can deduce one important practice in the judicial systems and the legal systems around the world. What we find here is known as the dissenting opinion of the minority during the judgment of a more than one judge bench. Then some judges stand out to disagree with the majority judgment, then they are dissenting. Dissenting is always occurring in contentious and the highly argued hard cases of the public interest. The Republic of Kenya, since the year 2010, the new constitution that was ushered in and which repealed the old constitution on the 27th August of 2010, Kenya has been experiencing the manifest of justice in a pragmatic way, in a progressive way. Progressive constitutional lawyers in Kenya of late have demonstrated some kind of capacity of knowledge in the area of the practice and how cases are litigated. This is not far from the American realism, in which the meaning of law is deduced from the arguments of learned advocates and learned judges, the senior counsels, and also those who are young lawyers. This is how the building of the jurisprudence is seen, because of new concepts being generated from time to time. But this is also guided in practice by a lot of research, academic work, certain input from the law scholars and professors of law, and those who have published widely. This has been demonstrated in earnest of late in the Republic of Kenya. I would like to begin by looking at two material cases. And I would begin with the Supreme Court, the presidential petition of 2017. On 1st September of 2017, the judges of the Supreme Court, while reading out their judgments, two judges stood out to be dissenting. And here I make reference to Honorable Justice Jackton Boma Ojwang and Honorable Justice Njoki Ndungu, who stood against the majority ruling, majority opinion. The same dissenting opinion has been witnessed on 20th of August 2021, when during the judgment of the Court of Appeal on the petition of the appeal on the BBI Bill ruling of the High Court. And in this case, I would like to make a clear and broad reference to the judgment made by Honorable Justice Fatuma Sichale, whose reading of the entire case impacted so much on the jurisprudence of the Constitution and constitutional law in the Republic and the knowledge about the law. Why do I say that it impacted? It impacted because it demonstrates what would refer to the freedom of expression, which is available to honorable judges due to the fact of the realism conception of the law. Judges have got that discretion to express their opinions, even if such opinions may not be supported by the majority opinion in the courtroom. In this case, dissent does not mean anything to do with winner and losers. It has so much to do with contribution to the jurisprudence, if you may. Because this is how knowledge is built around the law. And whenever we address ourselves to those dissenting opinions and judgments, one thing we should be aware of and acknowledge is that what has persuaded a particular judge to judge against the majority. The judgment of Justice Sichale that did not support or uphold the High Court ruling that declared the BBI bill as unconstitutional and void and null, basing the argument on the basic structure of the Constitution that can of course be amended, considering Chapter 16 of the Constitution and Article 255, Article 256 and Article 257. And in this case, the doctrine known today in Kenya as the Basic Structure Doctrine, which is not explicitly included in the texture of the Constitution, but it is implicitly included in the interpretation. This is the truth of the interpretation, making reference to Professor Dworkin on the interpretation, and also again making reference to several scholars and legal publicists who have come up with certain different opinions and theories, arguing that that basic structure of the Constitution should not be heavily relied on while interpreting the progressive constitution of Kenya, may amount to rejecting one truth, that Kenya is a common law system, and also Kenya has got the common law as part and parcel of the sources of law in the Republic. Another fact is that even if the basic structure concept is drawn from Kasabananda case by the Indian Supreme Court and has been commented on by different scholars and argued out by different able legal minds, constitutional lawyers, it still stands out as one of the major precedents in the common law regime. Remember that Kenyan courts have adversely and traditionally made reference to judge-made law, the so-called stare decisis. The same judge made reference to various theories, doctrines, and publications by different scholars of law, and this is what we are hereby acknowledging as contribution to the constitutional jurisprudence in Kenya. They see a constitutional revolution in which the people are realizing their constituent power, and in this case, the sovereignty of the people that is entailed in Article 1 of the Constitution, but also with the virtue of the preamble itself, in which it begins with "we the people of Kenya," and it concludes by giving this constitution to ourselves and to the future generations. And in my considered opinion, such ruling, that of the nullification of the presidential election of 2017, and this of the Court of Appeal, the High Court, that on the 20th August of 2021, on the BBI bill, still stand to be really a great breakthrough when it comes to the developing legal system, but also the developing judicial system in the Republic of Kenya. Cases and matters dealt with by the Kenyan competent courts and able and learned judges, such decisions and opinions become authority within the common law community, in which such cases are being studied on and also drawn into some kind of clear assessment and analysis by other jurisdictions. This is already an input, and it is not far from what we argue as developing an African jurisprudence, for instance. In doing this, we see the pragmatism, not activism. Activism is different from pragmatism. Pragmatism is the action, and it is the working, the intensive consideration and analysis of the subjects of law and justice, and without fear or favor, reading out the judgment by individual judges. This is what we consider as pragmatism and progressive way of looking at justice and law. Activism instead would mean something very different. Activism is more of political demonstration by calling for some kind of civil disobedience, or maybe going out to the street or shouting against some areas of injustice, or involving and engaging so much of the media, social media, and this is not what Kenya is doing. Bye, and thank you for being here.